Hello, Daz Studio enthusiasts. This is Not From This World, and I want to welcome you back to my tutorial series. Now, today I want to talk a little bit about something kind of interesting that I've just kind of started playing with recently, and that is this thing called the iRay Plane Node. And to find the iRay Plane Node, what you're going to do is come up here to Create, click on Create, and then drop down to where it says New iRay Section Plane Node. And you just select that and then hit Accept. And what it's going to do is kind of cool, but I'm still trying to kind of decide what I want to use it for. So what it's going to do is it's going to divide up your scene in iRay. And so if you are not in iRay, like I'm in texture mode here, you won't really see anything. And I'm going to kind of zoom out. And if you notice, scene tab, we've got the iRay section plane node selected right here. And if I go to iRay, what it's going to do is bisect the scene and get rid of anything that is above this iRay section plane node. So I can select it, and when I select it, I can move it up, and you can see that everything is disappearing above the iRay section plane node, and everything is visible underneath it. And it kind of helps if I go to the universal tool, because we can take and manipulate this plane node any way we want to. We can rotate it, we can mess with it. And when we do that, it's going to slice up our scene. And so you can see it's really weird. And unfortunately, it does it to the entire scene and not just one thing. I wish that we could like select one object and then dissect, kind of cut the scene in half and cut that prop in half, but we can't do that. So as I've kind of played with this, you know, like right now I've got Milica cut in half, and you can see she is literally cut in half, which can be kind of cool if you want to do some anatomical things. But other than that, I mean, you know, this, just look how it's like cutting everything in half. So what do we use this for? I guess that is the big question. Well, what we can use this for is scene setup. So for example, if I take this and move it, I can get rid of a wall or some other item within the scene to render. And so for example, I can take Milica's bedroom and we can cut out a wall, or we can cut out the ceiling, something like that, to let light in so that we can render and make perhaps a more lit up scene or something like that. And so if I go to perspective view, I'm just gonna kinda zoom out. You can see the way that I have this sliced, I have Milica in her bedroom here, and this plane node is slicing right through the bedroom. So see, if I get rid of this, you can see that her bedroom is a block. I already have the ceiling hidden just to let light in. But if we turn that plane node on, it is cutting across. So this is really a way that you can render an iRay and open up your scene so you can render with more light and that kind of thing. It's really kind of cool. I still am playing with it. I wish that it didn't have so many limitations. I really wish we could select an item like a chain and put a plane node on the chain, and it would only affect the chain in the scene. That would be a great way to hide like large sections of things, but we can't do that with this plane node, unfortunately. And I learned about this by watching a different tutorial where he created this plane node and just used blocks, which, you know, I guess is pretty cool. I'm not really a block person, but what's really cool is as you do this, you'll be able to see like how it cuts things in half, and you move this plane node around and you can see how it's cutting my sphere and my cube. And so that's kind of cool. You can kind of play with it. I really don't know what you would do with this other than just get rid of part of the scene to render easier. So if you use this for something specific, let me know, because I'm kind of playing with it. I'd like to, you know, use it more if it comes in handy. All I'm using it for right now is, like I said, to hide parts of the scene to get a better render. So like with Milica here, we can see that she's really lit up. Let's just look how she is. I mean, it's not making that much of a difference when we hide the plane node. But if you have like sun and sky in here, it's really going to change how that works. And you can see that it does affect the shadowing and things like that. So it has its limitations, but I just wanted to briefly show this to you because I thought it was kind of cool. And plus that, you know, I kind of have Milica in a cute outfit sitting on her bed, and that's always good to show. So I hope you enjoyed this. Let me know what you use this plane node for, if you use it, and if you've even heard of it. It's kind of a new thing for me. I mean, it's always been in this create menu, but I've never really played with it. So what do you think about it? Let me know, and I'm interested in hearing your comments. All right, well, play with this. Don't forget to like, subscribe if you haven't done it, and give me those comments. In the meantime, happy rendering and have a great weekend.